A very good morning, children. Today, we are going to start a new lesson. Last time I could not complete it because your exam was at hand. I cannot explain it properly. Okay. So today, we are going to learn lesson number 18, and the topic is sentences based on structure. Structure means how they are made of. Okay. So you can decide what kind of sentence it is: simple, complex, compound, or complex compound. Okay, four categories are there: simple sentence, complex sentence, compound sentence, and compound complex sentences. Like in the previous lesson, I had taught you about sentences, phrases, and clauses. So let me remind you, a sentence is a group of words which has a subject, a verb, and makes complete sense. That is sentence, okay? A phrase is a group of words which does not have a subject or a verb. It does not make complete sense. It does not give you complete idea. It just gives you some hint. Now the clause. Clause is a group of words which has a subject, a verb, and makes complete sense, and it is a part of a longer sentence. Okay, it is a part of a longer sentences. Sentence is independent. It does not need any help. But clauses are dependent, means they are connected with other sentences. They will give you complete meaning, but by joining with the other sentences, that is clause. So today we are going to read about the structure of sentences like simple, compound, complex, and complex compound. Let us see the definitions here. What is it? Sentences, four categories there. Simple sentence. Which kind of sentence is a simple sentence? One independent clause means, independent means it does not need any help. It is free. Without the help of any other sentence, it will give you complete meaning. That is independent. That is simple sentence means it is independent clause. Means it has a subject and a verb, and it gives you complete meaning or complete sense. Next is compound, two or more independent clauses. Here, simple sentence has only one clause. Okay. But when two clauses are joined together, they become compound sentence. In a compound sentence, there are two independent clauses. See again. Simple sentence, one independent clause, only one. Compound sentence, two or more independent clauses. In compound sentence, two or more independent clauses are there. Now, what is a complex one? Complex one is independent clause with one or more dependent clause. Now, what is dependent? I told you, independent, free. They do not need anybody's support or help. But dependent, they need support and help. Now, you see, your parents are earning money. Okay? They have a business. They do not depend on any other for survival. They have their own business. They are independent. But you are small children, school going children. You're not earning any money, just getting knowledge. But for your food, your clothes, and everyday needs, you are dependent on your parents. You cannot survive with your parents. Let me give you one more example. India became independent on 15th August 1947. Means before 1947, India was under British rule. India was not free. But after 15th August 1947, India became free. It did not help need the help of the British government. It became independent. So here you see, this is quite difficult. You must be careful. What is complex? Complex means it's a mixture. Remember, simplest term something. Complex means mixture. Okay. Complex. One independent clause. See, simple one independent clause. Complex also one independent clause. Okay. But what is the difference? Clause with one or more dependent clause. Mainly one simple clause will be there and two more dependent clauses will be there. See, a clause, independent clause can give you complete idea. It does not need the help of any other sentence. But dependent clauses, it cannot give you complete idea unless it is joined by simple sentence. One simple sentence with two more dependent clauses, they make a dependent clause. Now, what is compound and complex? It's combination. Compound and complex is combination. Okay, so let's see. Complex, at least two independent clauses. You see, in complex, one independent clause. Remember that step by step again. In complex, one independent clause. In compound, at least two independent clauses with one or more dependent clauses. Okay, clear. Let's see. Simple, it has only one independent clause. Compound, it has two or more independent clauses. Complex, one independent clause with one or more dependent clauses. Compound and complex, at least two independent clauses with one or more dependent clause. What is a dependent independent clause? Let us see. Independent clause has a subject. It's just like a sentence. Independent clause has a subject, has a verb, and it can stand on its own. It does not need the support of any other phrases or sentences. Okay, that is independent. Now, dependent is just the opposite of independent. See, independent clauses has a subject, a verb. Dependent clause also has a subject and a verb. Okay. And makes complete sense in itself, but dependent and makes no complete sense in itself. Independent sense clause gives you complete sense, but dependent clause does not give you complete sense. It depends on others to give the complete sense. It needs the help of others. Okay, so let us see the definitions given in the book. See, there is a structure given there. Simple, one independent clause. Compound, two or more independent clauses. Complex, one independent clause with one or more dependent clauses. Compound and complex, at least two independent clauses with one or more independent clauses. Now, there are some page 88, exercise A. You have learned about sentences before. Yes, we have learned in the previous lesson. Point out whether the sentence below are simple, complex or compound. Now, what is a simple sentence before attempting? Simple sentence is one and independent. Okay, that is simple. Next is complex. What is complex? One independent clause with one or more dependent clauses. Simple, independent. It does not need the help of any other sentence. Complex, it is a dependent clause with one or more dependent clauses. Okay, then next is compound. What is a compound sentence? Compound sentence is a mixture of two or more independent clauses. See, simple, only one clause. Compound, two or more clauses, and complex, one independent clause with one or more dependent clauses. Okay, this you do as homework. Page number 88, exercise A is your homework. Then page number 89, exercise B. Read the examples given below and fill in the blanks with sentences that follow. I'll just give you one or two examples. Okay. The sun rose on the distant horizon. You have to write in a simple sentence. Okay. The sun rose in a distant horizon. Do you know the meaning of horizon? See, especially late in the evening, when the sun is setting, the sky has a beautiful orange color. At a point, you'll see the sky has touched the earth, the mountains. Okay, the sky line has touched the mountain line, and that line is called horizon. There's no such line, but we see that. So, in sentence number one, the sun rose on the distant horizon. The subject of the first sentence is the sun. We are talking about the sun. And its predicate is rose on the distance. Basically, a sentence can be divided into two parts. You know, the part of speech, okay? One is subject part and the other is a predicate part. So here, the instruction is to find out the subject and the predicate. So the sun is the subject, rose on the distant hill is the predicate. Now, sentence number two. He felt rested enough and decided to resume his journey. Resume means continue. So what you have to do? Two independent clauses joined by an in the second sentence are, which are the independent clauses? He felt rested and decided to return, resume his journey. Means two sentences are joined together by the conjunction and. Alright, this you have to do, or you have done, I don't know. Come to page number 90. Using the words given in the box, combine the simple sentences to make a compound sentence. One has been done as an example. You see, this is the example. Simple. Hurry up, you will miss bus. Compound. Hurry up or else you will miss the bus. Okay. I'll just do one or two from this one. He worked very hard. His results are very good. How will you change into compound? We managed to reach, sorry, number one. He worked very hard, that is one. His results are good, that is two. You have to combine and make it what? Compound sentence. You have to join it like this. He worked very hard and his results are very good. Very simple step. He worked very hard and his results are very good. You have to use the conjunction. Okay, second one. We managed to reach in time. We got tickets. Two simple sentences are there. You have to join them and make them into compound. We managed to reach in time, so we got tickets. Okay. Now next group, exercise D, page number 91. Using the words given in brackets, combine the two sentences into a complex. One has been done for you. How to? Simple. I will be busy. My exams get over at the end of this month. Until. Okay, now, complex. I will be busy until my exams get over at the end of this month. Number one. Aisha is a hard-working girl. That is one sentence. She is somewhat slow in her working. Two sentences. You have to join them using although. So, I'll tell you. Aisha is a hard-working girl. Although she is somewhat slow in her work. The two simple sentences we have changed into complex sentence. Number two. My science paper is on Thursday. It is the last day of examination. Two sentences are there. You have to change into complex. Like how? My science paper is on Thursday, which is the last day of the examination. Likewise, you complete it. Okay. I think many of you have not completed. So I am giving you this as homework. Get it done and I shall correct it next time. Till next time, bye children.